rolling to the left, dog. She gon' see some shit that she don't wanna see. She ain't ready for it. If I ain't the greatest, then I'm headed for it. Yeah, that mean I'm way up. Yeah, the six ain't friendly, but that's where I lay up. This shit a motherfucking lay up. Being Steph Curry with the shot. Being cooking with the sauce. Chef Curry with the pot. What? 360 with the wrist, boy. Who the fuck the niggas is, boy? Holy yo, man, we really with the shits, boy. Yeah. Really with the shits. I should probably start a hit, boy, cause I got all the hits, boy. Fuck all that Drake, you gotta chill shit. I be on my little mouse drill shit.
It was, the second one here in Project 360. Tougher than the first, for sure. Also, there's a swim and a run beforehand, but the workout itself is tougher. So, anyways, that was good. Good stuff. So, after this, I'm gonna show you a 10-minute ab workout. It's a good one. It's a good ab workout. So before I just show you this little workout, and you can follow along with me, so I'm not going to be speeding it up, so I'm going to just be voiceovering it. You can watch it at first and then kind of do it along with me later once you learn the exercises. And if you have any questions on any of them in particular, then I can address them. But I thought it'd just make it a little bit easier before I show you this core workout, if I just explain a little bit as to, like, what exactly am I referring to when I say your core? Because I think a lot of people think of, you know, oh, you're doing a core workout, so, you know, you're working your six pack. But it's actually not really. Your rectus abdominis, that six pack kind of muscle that people refer to, it's actually very, like, it's the most superficial layer of your core, of your abdominal muscles. Is your core is, I like to think of it like a box. And your core, just like a box, there's a top, a bottom, and there's sides to it. And so the core, really the true core, the deepest layers of the core, made up of four different muscles, okay? So at the top of your box is your diaphragm. At the bottom of your box is the pelvic floor. The going around, the three sides going around is your transverse abdominis. It's kind of like a corset. And then at the back of the corset, meaning the back of the box, is multifidus. And those four muscles together are, you know, your true core, your true deep core muscles, okay? And then on top of it, you have your internal obliques and external obliques and rectus abdominis and stuff like that, the ones that get all the praise. But really, it's these four muscles that are what's doing the heavy lifting. It's these four muscles that give us stability in all directions, doing all movements throughout all activities in daily life. And you can build off of it for sure. So what I like to do, what I like to think of it is you have to build this foundational layer, this deep layer of core muscles before you start adding on all these other things around it. So it's a great thing to do this workout that I'm gonna show you, and then actually do some of your weightlifting. So doing your deadlifts and your squats and stuff like that, because for sure when you're doing those bigger movements, you're gonna have to have a strong core. You're gonna have to keep your core engaged as you do those exercises. So this just kind of reinforces that. So on that, speaking to, you know, your core muscles, like I'm saying, because I'm going to be referring to it in the video, what does it mean when I say activate your TA, transverse abdominis, that corset muscle, or pelvic floor? How do you do that? Because it's kind of, it's complicated. You know, everyone can flex their abs. But what does it mean to, you know, activate TA, to activate pelvic floor? So for pelvic floor, what I like to think, I could do a whole separate video on this, but just to keep it simple for now, for pelvic floor, what I like to think of it as, there's no really other way of saying it. Sorry if this sounds, you know, a little rude or something like that, but there's really no other way to say it. You can even look online and it's explained the exact same way. But Basically, to activate pelvic floor, you want to feel like you're trying to hold in pee, as if you had to go pee, and you're trying to hold it in. So you want to draw that muscle upwards. Like I said, the pelvic floor is the base of that. So you want to draw that muscle up by holding it in like that, okay? That's how you activate pelvic floor. From there, TA. How do you activate TA? Well, TA, like I said, is this corset muscle going around, okay? The best way that I could think of describing it, you can look it up. There's a lot of videos on it. But the best way I like to think of is activate TA. It's as if you were trying to put on a very tight pair of pants, and you kind of have to do that motion of sucking in your waist or sucking in your stomach a little bit. That's activating TA, okay? The other way to think of it is if you are trying to draw your two hip bones closer together. So there's a string going between your two hip bones, and you want to bring those two together. So if you actually feel right by your hip bone right here, if you actually feel there and then try to draw that in like that, as if you were pulling on a tight pair of pants, you'll feel this muscle bulge up underneath your hand. That's TA. That means you got it. And with multifidus, a little bit more complicated, but basically activate TA and pelvic floor and try to draw kind of the two ends of your back together. It's kind of a hard thing to explain, but just try to, if you envision you have two points on the base of your back, try to draw those in together. It's a very small movement. It's one I'm personally struggling with quite a bit, but that's the best way I could think of it. All right, so let's get started with these exercises. I'll show you how to have a voiceover over it, and if you have any questions, just let me know. So I start the little routine with a few different stretches, kind of dynamic stretches, kind of getting after the hip flexors. I just find that by opening up your hips, it makes it a little bit easier to do the exercise that's coming after this. So I start with a straight on kind of hip stretch here, and you can see I'm kind of pulsing it. So I do 2 seconds on, 1 second off. And then I do that same exercise, but with a side bend to the opposite side. Again, 2 seconds on, 2 seconds off. That's getting more iliopsoas. And then you'll see I turn the back leg inwards, contract the glute, and you end up getting TFL with this exercise. So I just find it makes it easier to get after the next exercise if your hips are somewhat opened up, especially considering this is immediately after a bike. It's good to open the hips up. So you'll see I go on to the other side now. So again, I'm doing neutral, kind of straight on hip. You want to keep a posterior tilt in your pelvis and really contract that glute, and you'll feel the stretch right in the front of your hip. And so I'm not really doing a long stretch here, as you can see. It's just more 2 seconds on, 1 second a little off. And then you see I bend to the opposite side, again getting more iliopsoas. Make sure that the camera can see me too. And then you're going to see me turn that back leg in. Just making sure my upper body's up nice and tall. And we're getting TFL with this exercise. Now that the hips are opened up, you're just going to grab a pillow and put that underneath your hips. What you're then going to do is draw your abdomen off the pillow. So you're going to need a posterior tilt to do that. Activate TA and pelvic floor, and then just a very small movement of a leg raise. This is going to get after multifidus. So you're trying to really kind of think about bringing, bringing the two points on your back closer together. This is an exercise that, for me, I've been doing this now for a month and a half, and every single physio appointment that I've had since, it's getting better, but it's still not where it could be. So you can give it a try. It's a tough little movement. You want to maintain that posterior pelvic tilt as you're lifting that leg. And it's a tough little movement to do, actually. So anyways, I'm doing 10 repetitions in the set, and I did 3 sets here. After the set, you can see I roll the pelvis back forward, and then I posterior tilt it, and we go again for another 10. I could actually probably even do a smaller leg raise off the off the mat there. I could see it's collapsing downwards a little bit with it. Alrighty, so that's my tough exercise, really, in terms of technical exercises. Now we get into kind of the meat of things here. So we're going to be doing an exercise that's really called dead bugs, and we're going to kind of be progressing it. So I start with just a simple TA activation. I make sure everything's all set, right, with that, okay? And then you're going to go opposite arm, opposite leg, reaching to the ends of the mat. The key with this exercise is that you're making sure that your lower back stays glued down to that mat and your ribs aren't flaring up at all as your arm goes back. So I'm going to do 10 repetitions of these. Again, it's not a contest to see how far you can go. If you feel your lower back lifting off the mat, then you don't go any further. That's as far as you can go. And it'll get better over time. So again, you keep that lower back glued to the mat, ribs glued to the mat. I reset, make sure TA is going again. And now same sort of thing, but now the legs are raised. So this is your classic dead bug exercise. There I had to just reset a little bit. I was losing it just a tad. So again, it's not a contest how far you can go. It's not how fast you can go. It's how well you can do it with control, keeping that back glued to the mat, keeping your ribs glued to the mat, keeping TA and pelvic floor turned on this entire time. Now you're going to grab a weight. I'm using a medicine ball. I think that's best, but if you don't have one, you can use a dumbbell, same thing. Activate TA and pelvic floor and bring that ball back as far as you can. And the key is this is one, this one's going to try, it's going to want your ribs to go up. It's going to try to force them up off the bed and flare them up off the mat here. But you want to stop that and you want to go as far as you can before you feel like your ribs are starting to flare up. So you can see I'm not going fully all the way down to the floor. I can't control it that far. I go as back as far as I can before I feel like if I went an inch further, my ribs would come up. I do that same motion now, but now we're adding the legs into the mix. So same kind of leg motion as we did for the very first exercise, but now it's with weight with the arms. Again, with control, going as far as you can go before you feel like if you went an inch further, your back and ribs would come up off the mat. And finally, you can see where this is going. We lift the legs up. And now the hardest of that little series, having the weight over top with the legs raised. The weight over top, like I said, is going to really, really force you to stay cognizant and stay engaged, keeping the ribs down. Because it's going to be pulling them, wanting to pull them up off the mat. So again, it's 10 of each of those exercises. So you're done with the weight for now, so you put it to the side. Okay, now I'm using leg weights here. I think this is the best thing to do for this. This is a very difficult exercise coming up. If you don't have those first ones, you don't need to use the leg weights for this. Just do the exact same exercise that I'm doing here without the leg weights and that'll be fine. I've been building this exercise for a while now and I'm at the point where I feel like I can do it with the leg weights, keeping that control. The leg weights, compared to the, here I won't talk for a second so you can see what I'm going to do. So I'm just going to keep my hands up and I'm going to do that same exercise we did the first time. So whereas the ball is going to be kind of forcing you to keep your ribs down, it's going to be wanting your ribs to flare up and you're going to have to stop them from doing so. The leg weights, on the other hand, by pulling from the other side, are going to be wanting your, or are going to be trying to make your lower back arch and pull up off the mat, which is what you're trying to resist them doing. So it's pulling from the bottom this time. So 10 of those. Now you lift your legs up, the harder one, with control. This is a very difficult exercise. So again, if you don't have the first few, don't go to this one. This is something to build towards. So you're doing 10 repetitions of these. Keeping that lower back really glued down, the ribs glued down. It's a tough one to keep that lower back down. It's a very difficult exercise. So you're doing 10 of them. to do it properly, that is. You want to keep breathing throughout all these exercises, by the way. When people activate TA and pelvic floor, they tend to hold their breath. You want to keep breathing, obviously, the entire time. And now the trifecta. So we got a leg weight and we got arm weights. So this is the most difficult exercise in the entire series. It is a very difficult exercise. So you're going to do 10 of those. So your ribs are wanting to come up. Your lower back is wanting to come up. And I'm having to work with all my might with TA at its absolute best, activated 100%, to keep both of those from happening, to keep the lower back down and keep the ribs down. All right, that's it for those guys. Now you take the leg weights off, you're done with those, and we're going to move on to the next little series here. So at this point, your abs should be, you should be feeling it. I mean, that in its own, you can end the workout right there, and it's pretty good. You've got a good amount of work in. Like I said, if you don't have the leg weights, just do those without the leg weights. All right, so now we're going to our plank series. Just taking my watch off here so I get a time, so I can look at the time as I'm doing it. So we're going to do a straight up side plank here, and you're going to go for 30 seconds. So with the side plank, you really want to make sure your hips are high off the ground. So you're really actually with the side plank, you're working glute med quite a bit in addition to the obliques. But just like with the first ones, we're keeping TA and pelvic floor activated this entire time. Okay, so it's 30 seconds of this. Not hard. It'll get harder though. Things start adding up with this workout. So you take a 5 second pause, then you come right back up. And now the harder exercise, doing side leg raises with that side plank. The key is you make sure those hips don't drop down towards the mat as you raise that other leg up. And you're going to do 10 of those. Take a little pause. Offset your feet. And now you're going to do some twists. So you're reaching your arm underneath your body, really feeling, you know, you're rotating through the entire body, through the entire obliques. And you're going to do 10 of these. Again, it's not a contest how fast you can go. It's more about control as you're doing these and really feeling like you're getting a full rotation. That one was a bad one that I did, the last one that I did there. Probably getting a little tired. All right, so now you go to the other side. So same thing as the other. We're going to do a side plank for 30 seconds, straight up side plank. The easiest one. You can see I'm getting bored with that one. Bored after 10 seconds. This is a very easy one for me. The straight up side plank, that is. It gets harder as you go, for sure. But at this point, that side is fresh. It's ready to go. So, again, you're done the 30 seconds. You take a 5 second little pause. You get right back up, and now you do your leg raises. Now, my glute med on this side is not nearly as strong as the other side. So I do have to work at this one, and you can see I'm actually going even faster than the other side because I'm trying to keep the hips up. But again, you want to keep the hips up as you're bringing that other leg up. And again, finally, you finish with the twists. So really reaching underneath your body and getting a full rotation here. So you're going to really feel this in the obliques. Again, not you're not rushing it. You're not wanting to go a million miles a minute. You're just nice and control, getting a nice full rotation through. So 10 of those. Now we kind of combine the two twists and leg raise into one. So you collect yourself for just a minute. Come up into the side plank, leg raise, switch sides, leg raise, and you're going to do 10 of these. Leg raise, switch sides, leg raise. So it's a little bit more dynamic of a movement. So you're really combining all the motions. You can tell that I like doing things like this. I like starting with a simple one and I build and progress the movements. I kind of do this with all my workouts and all my exercises. So you're going to do 10 of those. And now we're done the side plank series. But we're not done with the obliques just yet. We're going to really finish them off with something very dynamic, which most of you have probably seen before. We're going to do 30 seconds of Russian twists. You can tell I'm learning from this video, even just seeing it. I don't rotate nearly as well going towards the left. It's interesting. It's a tiny little rotation going that way. Something I got to work on. That's why I like doing these videos, because I get to see it too. Anyway, so 30 seconds of the Russian twists. And now the harder of the two exercises for the obliques. I'm going to do something that at Mac we called the Crazy Ivans. So you bring that leg down, or the weight down, and you press it up. And you're going to do 12 of those. Go to the other side. So you're bringing it down as if you're doing the Russian twist, but instead of twisting to the other side, you're twisting and pressing up. You can see I'm hurting at this point. The obliques are cooked with the side planks and then those. And then our last series of exercises here, we're going to do a little front plank series. So we're going to do 3 of them. As you can see, I like doing series of exercises. So the first one in the series is you're going to do 10 straight leg raises just back, keeping that plank nice and stable as you raise the leg back. After you're done the 10, you hold for 15 seconds. See, I got quite a rounding of my back actually, and that's actually pretty typical for me. It's like that on the bike as well. I've always really had really a rounded back, the top part of my back there. So the next series, now you can see we're doing the arms. So we're going to do 10 little reaches with the arms, keeping a good plank, not looking up like I did there, keeping a good plank, and you're going to do 10 reaches. After we're done the 10 reaches, you're going to hold that plank just like we did before for 15 seconds. Man, that's a rounded back. The more I look at it, holy moly. Okay, and now the final exercise on the day. We're bringing both of those together. So we're going to do a leg raise with the reach. So the most challenging. And at this point in time, trust me, your abs are hurting. So forgive my form on a couple of them. I'm trying my best here. It's hard. Actually, it's pretty good. It looks pretty good. Not as good on the left side, but the right side's definitely good to go. So it's a reach with the leg raise, and then you're holding for 15 seconds. And the abs should be just pretty much cooked at this point. You've done 16 minutes here of pretty darn solid work for sure. And that's it. That's the exercises. So it's about 15 minutes. You can cut it down for sure. You know, if you don't want to do one of the series here or there, but I think it's a good little series of exercises to do. Again, thanks so much for watching. If you like, hit that like button, subscribe, hit that little notification icon so you can stay up to date on all my videos. I post every single day, and I'll see you tomorrow. Thanks so much for watching. Have a good day.